And what did you get signed by him, Fez?
I got a copy of the new book, also Less Than Zero, and American Psycho, copies of
Very
each of those.
Very nice.
So that's all signed by Bret Easton Ellis.
Very, very cool. I'm going to go over and look at his...
You
know what? I could just keep the three of these and have that as like, oh, I have a lot of signed books. Did you love those things in... that I brought up to him, Hicks, in American Psycho, where he would just go on and on about fucking bad music.
Oh, yeah. That was hysterical.
And that's how I get if somebody starts talking too much about Coldplay to me now. I'll be just like, what goes on in this lunatic's head? You just meet somebody who's into something white bread really strong. Sometimes when I hear Fez going on and on about American Idol and who should have won, it gives me an American Psycho thing. You don't like to read it off, Fez?
Nope. I have attempted it. I have picked up books.
You ever heard of this gentleman before he came in?
Honestly, no. I've heard of the books. I've heard of the movies.
Did you watch the movies?
I think I watched Less Than Zero years ago. But that was it. I haven't seen American Psycho or any of the other ones.
Brian, you're on Ron Fez Show.
Ron, first of all, Fez, you got to see American Psycho. I mean, it's a great movie. Never mind the book. It's crazy. But there's one part of American Psycho, Ron, that I don't know if you remember, but it really always struck a chord with me. And it's when they go out to these really, really fancy restaurants in the city, and they order these, like, $150 or $200 meals, and they don't eat anything. And I, you know, every time I go out to one of those restaurants, I'm always thinking about that. I don't know why.
Well, that's because he was with models and they were coked up. Everybody was coked up. So they went out to the place to be, you know, but it was almost like putting his status symbol in front of you. You know, you bring about this all the time. It's like some fucking guy who he's going to, let's say, go skiing. So he goes and gets the outfit, and he gets new skis and all, and maybe uses it once. And some other guy who, like, lives on a mountain, skis every day, could never afford any of this shit.
What's even funnier was when they would go to these downtown clubs dressed in their suits and just fucking doing gag in the bathroom and just standing out looking like dicks in, like, a punk club in the 80s.
It's still like that downtown. I mean, everyone will talk about the downtown scene, but the guys that go in these bars buying fucking Cristal and, you know, having the chicks around them are going to be those fast money guys. And the thing is, when you're overpaying like that, right, and you're in the money business, it shows that the whole money thing doesn't mean shit to you. It's almost like a dope dealer will get money, and because he didn't kind of properly earn it, he goes through it really fucking fast.
Oh, yeah.
The Wall Street guys are always the same way. They're just like, this is just fucking paper. Doesn't mean shit to me.
It's just worthless.
Dan has a moral conundrum for us. Hey, Dan.
Ron, how you doing?
Good.
All right, man. So, you know, I'm broke as shit right now. About 20 minutes ago, go to the bank. You have to actually go to the teller to take out some cash. I'm leaving the bank, find this chick's wallet on the ground out in the back, right? Mm-hmm. It's got a ton of cash in it. It's even got one of her paychecks. I'm definitely, you know, giving the wallet back, taking it in. Do I take the cash, though?
Now, why would you ask me that opinion? I mean, obviously, you're ready to do something that you know is wrong so you make a little fucking money for yourself. Why do you want me? Why do you want my karma involved in this?
Because Ronnie B, I need a bag, and if you tell me it's okay, it's okay.
Then it's not okay.
All right.
All right.
Thanks, brother.
Hand it all back in. I'm not going to have this set on my goddamn shoulders. This isn't my sin to carry. You got your own stuff.
You should steal it.
It's too late. You don't get anything out of that opinion.
And then find out where she lives from her address and rape her.
All right. See that? This is why we're on an XL. I'd like to be out there on a regular channel.
Burn her house down.
Let me just say this. Everything that Hicks said is a joke.
Should I dump out?
Yeah, dump out of yourself. I wish you could dump out of your life right now, the way you're going.
Me too.
I guess you basically have... You do have that sick indifference towards life.
Sometimes, yeah. Plus, I love Huey Lewis in the news.
That was really fucking cool.